Epic Games' actions these last number of months have made it crystal clear that they believe the best way, and really the only way, to disrupt the PC marketplace and create change is by catering to game publishers and developers rather than consumers. The reason the Epic Games PC store even exists is supposedly because of Steam's monopoly on PC gaming, but what Epic Games has been doing these last number of months to create supposed competition and try to give game developers, both big and small, a more fair profit split has proven to be divisive. The only reason why the Epic Games Store is having any success is because pretty much Epic has forced consumers to use their platform for certain games. Exclusivity deals in the eyes of Epic Games is the only way to truly hurt Valve. For months, with each new exclusive announcement from Metro Exodus to Borderlands 3 to Shenmue 3, Epic Games has found more and more ways to anger consumers, but during this time, other game companies like Microsoft and CD Projekt Red have taken a very strong stance against exclusivity, wanting to give gamers more choice and options. Still, Epic Games maintains that they are the good guys trying to slay the evil Valve, but if we're being honest, from a consumer perspective at the very least, it appears all Epic is doing is hurting the smaller competitors like GOG. Today we have a lot to discuss. There have been theories surrounding Cyberpunk 2077's outrage that erupted a few weeks ago, with some finding a connection to Epic Games, believing that there may be a campaign against CD Projekt Red, and just recently Epic CEO Tim Sweeney responded to those accusations. Also, Epic Games recently took direct hypocritical shots at Steam. They continue to buy up Kickstarter games, making them exclusives, and something actually not being discussed enough is how Epic is snatching up remasters and re-releases and making them exclusives. But before we get to that, if you haven't already, do consider subscribing for all the latest gaming news, and turn notifications on so you don't miss out on any new content. As most of you know, the hit piece articles being written about gaming YouTubers like myself are not slowing down, so do make sure to follow my other social media accounts and support the channel by simply sharing this video and leaving a like. So, Epic Games, really throughout 2019, has not been able to escape negative headlines, and the latest massive debacle happened with the Kickstarter-backed Shenmue 3, a game that only exists because of the dedicated fanbase who gave developer YSNet millions of dollars to develop it, and in return, backers were promised rewards like a Steam key. This has become a consistent theme with the outrage surrounding Epic Games snatching up Kickstarter-backed games. With Shenmue 3, it was announced over 4 years ago, and has been advertised with a Steam release, but only a number of months before release, that Steam launch has been pushed back by at least 12 months. Interestingly, the publisher behind Shenmue 3 is Deep Silver, the same slimy company who pulled similar nonsense months ago with Metro Exodus. Now, I'm not going to dive too deep into the situation, but Epic Games knows how to bring out the worst in this gaming industry. Of course, everyone understands these companies need to make money, but they also need to maintain good relationships with their communities, and what Epic has been doing is pretty much telling these game executives, here's a bunch of money, screw that established trust and promises, and ditch Steam. With Shenmue 3, what's even worse is how developer YSNet originally was not accepting refunds, telling angry backers who felt disrespected that they made this change because they believed it would be the best distribution platform option, which I find that both laughable and kinda stupid. Honesty is something this industry has difficulty grappling with. Everyone knows it was about the money, that's it, simple as that. The Epic Games Store for consumers currently sucks, and doesn't even measure closely to any of the other PC store competitors, like GOG or Steam. The one upside, if you can call it that, is Epic CEO Tim Sweeney recently announced they would personally deliver on Shenmue 3 refunds, saying in a statement, Epic is funding the cost of all Kickstarter refunds resulting from Shenmue 3's move to the Epic Games Store, so that refunds won't reduce YSNet's development funding. When future games go Epic exclusive after offering crowdfunding rewards on other PC stores, we'll either coordinate with colleagues at the other stores to ensure key availability in advance or guarantee refunds at announcement time. While I am happy that misled backers are getting refunds, this response is not a solution that can be accepted, as it doesn't really solve the core issue, which is game companies breaking their promise to consumers. Whether it be Shenmue 3 or Phoenix Point or The Outer Worlds or whatever game is inevitably next, all this has done is made a lot of people not want to back Kickstarter projects because of the real possibility that promises will be broken. I really do wonder the negative effects or damage that Epic Epic Games has created thus far. But beyond just Kickstarter or indie or AAA games being announced as exclusives, another issue that's been under the radar up to this point is Epic going after remasters and re-releases. Twitter user Casey Explosion was the first to point this out, but a few months ago, all of Telltale's games were removed from CD Projekt's GOG, and most have been removed from Steam. This is happening because of the studio's closure, but Telltale's biggest franchise, The Walking Dead, did make a return, exclusively to the Epic Game Store, and soon The Walking Dead, the Telltale definitive series, will be exclusively released on the Epic Game Store. More concerning, Ghostbusters, the video game, was removed from Steam 2 years ago with no explanation, and just recently it was announced that the game would be receiving a remaster, and would be yet another exclusive coming to the Epic Game Store. What's odd about this situation is the fact that game publishers like Bethesda in the past have offered the upgraded version of Skyrim free for those who already own the original edition on Steam, or even Bandai Namco with From Software's Dark Souls Remastered gave Steam owners of the original version a 50% discount. But with Epic Games entering into the fold, it really does seem things have changed, because those who did own the original Ghostbusters game will not receive a discount or get the new edition for free. They will pay full price on a different client. I mean, this clearly could become a more evident problem as we move forward, with publisher generosity being replaced with greed, all because Epic Games thinks that they are creating competition. The Epic Games Store has been attracting a lot of criticism, and with anger surrounding the decisions made by the company growing, a lot of theories are being made. One of the stores most affected by the introduction of the Epic Games Store is CD Projekt's GOG. It was reported by Kotaku earlier in the year that some staff were let go because of revenue falling, and with Cyberpunk 2077's big reveal at E3 2019, CD Projekt Red began taking pre-orders and encouraged those wanting to support them 100% to buy the game from their company-owned PC store, although they, of course, were not forcing anyone into using just their store, as they offered players choice with having the game available for purchase just about everywhere. CD Projekt Red in the past has been vocal about not making Cyberpunk 2077 an Epic Games Store exclusive, something that may seem obvious being that they own a store, but nonetheless, that public announcement was applauded by many. Either way, GOG, like Steam, is definitely more consumer-focused than the Epic Games Store, which, with the abysmal availability of features still, it's pretty obvious publishers and developers are the focus for Epic. Because of that, there's a lot of people believing that Epic Games is trying, intentionally or not, to take down CD Projekt and Valve stores. As most of you know, Rock Paper Shotgun published a few hit piece articles on Cyberpunk 2077 during E3 2019, which created quite a bit of misguided outrage. This led to many more articles from Polygon, Eurogamer, and various other outlets, which covered and gave their opinion on the criticism being thrown at CD Projekt Red, which, might I add, again proved to be misguided nonsense. But anyway, recently YouTubers The Mad Queen Show, the Triple S League, and Upper Echelon Gaming covered the motivation potentially behind the negativity thrown at CD Projekt Red's Cyberpunk 2077. The theory was, or is, that by going down the rabbit hole and finding out who was invested in these gaming outlets, there is a link specifically to Epic Games, and it created a question of if Epic is trying to damage CD Projekt Red. Personally, I think these theories are a little too out there, and I find it more believable that outlets like Rock Paper Shotgun just have, well, crappy clickbait takes. Now, videos like this one from the Triple S League, which many of you contacted me about for the last week, states that while nothing can be entirely proved, there just is some odd connections and relationships that people need to know about. But I will acknowledge that there have been divisive figures trying to capitalize on the anger being thrown at Cyberpunk 2077. Anita Sarkeesian trying to stir up drama based on misinformation to get a consultant job, I guess. But as we later found out, Anita's nonprofit organization has gone broke. So it's kind of clear now what the motivation was behind that criticism of CD Projekt Red, which is why I do believe questioning and investigating potential motives is important. Either way, the Triple S League on Twitter did get a response from Epic CEO Tim Sweeney, who said, "Epic has absolutely nothing to do with that. CD Projekt Red is an Epic partner we greatly respect. They currently are taking pre-orders through the Epic Game Store, and we're big fans of their efforts to connect ecosystems with GOG GOG Galaxy. Now, a Twitter user would hit back pointing out that even with him saying that, his investors may feel differently, seeing CDPR's GOG Galaxy 2.0 as trouble, and being that Tencent has large investments in multiple game companies from Epic Games to Activision Blizzard, Ubisoft, and Paradox, I can understand concerns. And it doesn't even stop there, as just last year, Epic received $1 billion-plus investment from various companies. All of this comes with valid skepticism of just how independent Epic really is. But Sweeney would respond saying, "How so? GOG Galaxy's stated goal is to connect all of your games from all storefronts together in one place. Sounds good. Anything that reduces fragmentation among launchers puts the Epic Game Store and other independent stores on a more even footing with Steam. And furthermore, everybody putting all of their games on the dominant storefront so it can stay dominant and charge everyone 30% forever is not free market competition at all. What we're seeing now is very robust competition, Epic on developer terms, GOG on features, Microsoft on business model." The thing that I take issue with Tim Sweeney's response to criticism is making it seem like Epic Games and its investors don't have billions of dollars invested into this store. They can make it seem like they are trying to create competition, but in all honesty, with all the money they are throwing at game companies for exclusives, of course they are trying to slay the evil Valve and take their spot. Recently, Valve had a bit of a mess on their hands. The Steam Summer Sale created a lot of confusion, leading to many players removing indie titles from their wishlists. The expectation many had was that by deleting indie games from their wishlists and leaving highly anticipated AAA games on the list, it would ensure they could get those games for free from the Steam Summer Sale Grand Prix event, if they are lucky enough to win it. As Valve admitted, the event was poorly explained, and they did not make clear enough that all you need to do is to rank your wishlist and put the game you want the most at the top, which you'll get if you do win. No need to delete anything. Now, there were and have been other issues facing this racing event, but largely this summer sale appears to be running smoothly. But Epic Games CEO Tim Sweeney did take the opportunity to throw some shade at Valve, first tweeting a video that I suppose was making a point that Epic had a better sales event for a summer or spring. Tim Sweeney would further add about the actual issues hitting Valve's sales event, saying, "There's a lot to digest here, I don't know what to make of it, but surely all the big publishers will be watching to see if gamers accept competitive metagames where purchasing drives randomized economic rewards." And later he would tweet, I believe again in reference to this event, "WTF, PC gamers love surprise mechanics now." And I mean, there is a clear difference here with you having the possibility of getting something for free on top of taking part in the sales event. But honestly, I just find this all extremely hypocritical considering how Epic's first mega sale blew up in their face because publishers, or big publishers like 2K Games and Paradox, pulled their games temporarily from the Epic Game Store to avoid allowing players to purchase games like Borderlands 3 and Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines 2 for $10 off the $60 price tag. The belief is that they did this because Epic did not communicate properly with these publishers what this sales event was all about. And also, many big publishers don't like discounting games before release, even with Epic footing the bill because it's not a good look. So, in conclusion, I definitely do think Steam can do more for developers, but at the same time, I just don't see how the Epic Game Store is creating positive change by forcing people into using their lackluster platform. I mean, the Epic Game Store launched about 8 months ago, and many basic features like a shopping cart is still not here. Personally, the PC store I feel gamers should be backing is GOG. Besides the amazing opposition to DRM that the store is committed to, CD Projekt actually gave me early access to GOG Galaxy 2.0, and thus far I personally am loving having one place where all my games are connected. That is CD Projekt's solution to not just Epic Game Store versus Steam, but other clients like EA's Origin or Activision Blizzard's Battle.net. Now, even with this good, I do think that the Epic Game Store is just damaging a lot of the smaller PC marketplaces, intentional or not, with exclusivity, which has me concerned for the future. Nobody really knows when Epic Games will stop, or if they will ever stop with exclusives. And what's stopping another massive company like Amazon from swooping in and doing the exact same thing? Epic wants to create competition, but they also want to be one of the major stores of the future. Let's not act like the motivation behind taking down Valve is something just about getting developers a more fair profit split. Epic is investing boatloads of money into exclusives to ensure that once the Fortnite money starts to dry up, that they will have a profitable future ahead with their store. Epic can claim that they aren't trying to hurt stores like GOG, but it's quite clear that they kinda are. Anyway, we've had months of this madness surrounding the Epic Games Store, and it doesn't appear anything will be changing soon. So, has your opinion shifted at all about the battle between Epic and Valve? Let me know your thoughts down in the comment section below. But thank you for watching, make sure to leave a like if you did enjoy this video or found any informative value, and make sure to follow my other social media accounts for updates on new videos. Links are always down in the description below. I'm most active on Twitter, giving opinions on news that I do not always get into video form, so make sure to follow me over there. Also, check out my Discord for all sorts of discussion on games. And again, thank you for joining. Consider subscribing for more videos like this, and I'll see you later.